JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for August the 10th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar outperformed all the other major currencies on Friday, Monday, and Asian session Tuesday. It gained the most versus CHF, NZD, and AUD in that order, while it eked out the least gains against the Japanese yen. The strengthening of the dollar, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, and the fact that the yen lost the least ground, suggests that markets traded in a risk-off fashion. However, shifting attention to the equity world, we see a rather mixed picture, although we saw some improvement late in the Asian session today. Appetite appeared much more subdued in the commodity market, with oil and gold prices falling on Friday and opening with negative gaps on Monday. Although they recovered somewhat afterwards, they remain well below their Friday openings. The big driver behind the rally in the US dollar and partly behind the slump in commodity prices may have been the better than expected US employment report for July, which was released on Friday. Non-farm payrolls rose more than expected, with the unemployment rate sliding below its own consensus. Earnings exceeded their forecasts as well, with Fed Chair Powell noting at the press conference following the latest FOMC meeting that the labor market has still a long way to go. The jobs report came to undermine his remarks, and combined with hawkish comments by several other policymakers, including Vice Chair Clarida, added to speculation that the Fed may need to start tapering its quantitative easing purchases sooner than previously anticipated. This could also mean sooner rate hikes as well. Indeed, according to the Fed Fund futures, the timing of when market participants expect the Fed to proceed with the first 25 basis points increase has come slightly forth to March 2023 from April 2023, ahead of the report. Now, oil and gold prices may have also felt the heat of concerns around the spreading of the coronavirus Delta variant, which resulted in new restrictions in Asia. However, there appears to be a disconnect with the equity world, where although investors appeared careful, they kept major indices near their records. Perhaps they want to take advantage of extra low interest rates before it is too late. As for our view, with what we have in hand now, we would expect this pattern to continue, namely the dollar to continue gaining and commodity and commodity-linked currencies to continue underperforming. As for the equities, although we could see some retreat due to more cautiousness, we cannot rule out fresh highs in the days to come. That said, a lot may also depend on the US CPI data for July due out on Wednesday. Another set of extremely high numbers, well above the Fed's objective of 2%, may add to the view that the surge in inflation is not transitory, and thereby increase further the chances for an earlier normalization by the Fed. If indeed the CPIs solidify the case for the Fed to start withdrawing stimulus soon, perhaps in September, market participants may then start examining hints and clues on the pace of the normalization process. Currently, the Fed is buying $120 billion worth of assets per month, So a 20 billion taper means that the program will end in 6 months and thereby allow even earlier rate hikes, while withdrawing only half of that amount would take a full year. We may get more information on that front at the Jackson Hole Economic Symposium scheduled later this month. Now, as for today's events, the calendar appears relatively light today with no major market movers on the agenda. During the European session, we have the German ZW survey for August. The current conditions index is expected to have risen to 30 from 21.9, while the economic sentiment one is forecast to have slid to 57 from 63.3. Although the current conditions index is suggesting that the economic recovery in Eurozone's growth engine continues despite fears over the Delta variant of the coronavirus, the economic sentiment reveals cautiousness for the future. Therefore, we don't expect the euro to receive any support if this is the case. With the ECB signaling through its new guidance that it is now willing to keep interest rates low for much longer than the previous guidance suggested, and with expectations around an earlier Fed action growing recently, we believe that the path of least resistance for euro-dollar remains to the downside. With regards to the energy market, we get the American Petroleum Institute to report on crude oil inventories for last week, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. As for the speakers, we have one on today's agenda, and this is Chicago Fed President Charles Evans. Following the relatively dovish remarks by Fed Chair Powell at the press conference after the latest policy gathering, several officials, including Vice Chair Clarida, sounded more hawkish. Thus, it would be interesting to see whether Evans is among those agreeing with Powell, or whether he will also join the hawkish camp, advocating for earlier tapering and or earlier rate hikes. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.